you an influencer or an aspiring influencer on Instagram that maybe is feeling a little bit lost, maybe feels need a little bit of tough love to kind of get back on track and help you reach your goals of being an influencer? If that is you, you are in the right place, because in today's video, I'm going to share some of my favorite tips that I love to give my influencer clients during my one-on-one coaching and in my group coaching. So if you are new to my channel, welcome. My name is Nina Zeta. I am the co-founder of Sidewalker Daily. I work with brands on their influencer marketing, and I also work with influencers to help them be better business owners. So I'm in this really cool space in between both. I like to say I'm on both sides of the equation. And today's video is really for my influencers, my Instagram influencers, particularly because I hear you guys in my group coachings and my one-on-one clients, and I hear the things that you guys are going through and the things you need help with. So I wanted to put together kind of like a recap video to share some of my top tips for influencers on Instagram to help you guys keep going, keep at it, and keep doing what you love. Now, before I jump into my long list of tips, this is going to be a big one, guys, because I go into a lot. I want to make sure you guys subscribe to this channel, hit that little bell so that you can be notified the next time we release a video. And I like to focus on all things influencer marketing and social media, just for the newbies here, so you guys know what type of stuff we post. Okay, so my first tip for the influencers that are watching is to really focus on the word influence. And do you have it? People tend to get so caught up with followers and numbers and growth and blah, 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 blah. And then they forget what being an influencer is really all about, which is being influential, having influence, being a leader, right? It's not just buying followers and getting a fake amount of numbers and having no true influence. How lame is that? What you really need to focus on is your influence, building that trust with your community, being a true thought leader in your space, being someone that people come to for questions, for advice. That's kind of what you guys want to position yourself, right? Sadly, the idea of just posting pretty photos, those days are long gone. What you need to focus on is the influence side and constantly testing your influence to make sure that you are really active with your audience, that you have a strong connection with them. That is what being an influencer is about. Another thing that I think is important to add to that point about, you know, working on your influence is also responding, right? We often talk about like, oh, we have to engage, engage, engage. But like, do you respond to every single comment on your page? Do you respond to every DM? Think about it. This is a human at the other end of the screen that took time to say, wow, that was amazing. Like, or this, that, the other. Are you ignoring that human, or are you bringing them in? Are you like bringing them, you know, making them feel special? Because one of the things about also being an influencer is like, you have to ask yourself, who is your client? And for a lot of influencers, I think your audience really is your client, right? You're trying to produce content, not just to make them happy, but to add value. So if your client or prospective client or someone that, you know, you're trying to have influence over comes over and leaves a comment, I expect you guys to write back to all of them. Yes, I know it's a pain, but it's part of the job. So I would strongly suggest to carve out a little bit of time to be part of your daily tasks to respond and engage, you know, with the people that engage with you. Now, another thing I think is super important in the influencer world, and I see this again, time and time again with so many of my clients, they want to talk about everything under the sun, and they get so mad at me when I like drill down the importance of niching down and getting yourself a niche. At the end of the day, guys, it's about getting there faster. If you want to be all over the place, that's fine. It's just going to take you longer. If you're niche and known about one thing, you'll just get there faster because you're going to build that trust with your community. And then down the road, you can pivot, you can change. People will already be there for you. So focus on being niche, getting a niche. And if you're like, well, what do I do? How do I even know what that is? Just start by saying, what do people come to me for? What are the top questions in my DMs? What are the frequently asked questions? What are the things that I can solve? And another way to think about it is, who was I a few years ago? Like, who am I in a good position to teach or to talk to or to give value? Those are things that can help you define your niche. Now, I'm going to keep going down this long laundry list, but I did want to say, if you are having trouble deciding who you are, your niche, I think this is a fundamental piece of the equation because so many things follow this. Without setting this piece of the pie, like without setting this little equation, everything else just kind of doesn't make sense without knowing who you are and who you want to be online. So if you do need help with this portion, you can work with me on one-on-one. private Zoom calls or group coaching. And I'm going to leave both links below. If you want to be in a group setting with other creators and more of like a classroom vibe, then there's that. And then if you want one-on-one, which is like private tutoring, you can have that as well. Okay, so let's jump into my other tip, consistency. You will hear this again time and time because consistency is where it's at. I have a creator who literally was telling me she posts on Reels 2 times a day. It's a lot of work. Like, no one said being an influencer was going to be easy. People have this idea of like, I post pretty photos and I'm just going to be like famous on Insta. And that's just not it. The people that are doing this for a living, full-time business, know how hard it is because they're spending a lot of time creating and being consistent in their content, not only in the style of the content, but in their posting. I hate to break it to anyone that is watching this, but Instagram is a type of place that you will be easily forgotten if you don't keep up. It's just that type of platform. Information is flowing, flowing, flowing. When you don't post, you kind of just get forgotten. There's that fear of missing out, that FOMO. And if that resonates with you, then Instagram is a good place for you because you got to keep up. That means posting on stories. That means showing up for your audience. That means creating content even when you don't want to, or batching it ahead of time and scheduling it out. Whatever works best for you, but know that consistency is super important. And by the way, that's not just with Instagram, that's just in business. Even on YouTube for us, like, we have to be consistent in our posting. And when we fall behind, it affects us, algorithm, it affects my audience, everything. So being consistent is a driver for your business. Now, a big tip I love to give my influencers, my influencer clients, is keeping things fresh. Now, what do I mean by that? Your bio, keep it fresh. Your stories, keep it fresh. No one wants to see highlights that are like 386 weeks old, okay? I have gone into some of my clients' highlights and I've clicked on them and I'm like, why do you have something that's literally like 200 weeks old? Again, depending on your monetization, do you want to work with brands? Who are you going to? But regardless, if someone clicks on your story and sees old material, that's exactly how it feels, old. So as an influencer, go in there, be on top of your business, treat your Instagram like the front door to your business. Are you gonna have cobwebs on your retail door? No, right? So why are you having old, crusty stories and your highlights? I'm sorry to be so crass, but it's true. Like, it's the front door to your biz. If you're on Instagram and you're an influencer on Instagram, your Instagram needs to be fresh. Things need to feel good and fluid. So make sure that you are keeping your content fresh, but also your bio and your highlights and your stories. Now, as an influencer, you're probably saying, I want to grow my audience. How do I do that? So one of my favorite tips is networking with other influencers and borrowing their audience. So this means you can collaborate with people with the intention of getting exposure on their platform. So if you're an influencer working with another influencer in your space, this is awesome. This is super, super important for you because you're going to not only network for yourself, but you're also gonna be able to get access to their audience, right? That's what you want. You want other new people that would be interested in you to follow. Reach out to them, collaborate, borrow their audience. And not only for you to get visibility from their audience, but you never know, those may be the same people that give you work in the future. Like, oh, hey, I can't take this campaign. Do you want it? This happens all the time. So behind the scenes, people are sharing contacts, they're helping each other, they're building friendships. So definitely network with other influencers as a way to grow. Now, another huge tip for my influencers. Now, again, this is because you want to be an influencer. Gotta break it to you. You have to share a lot. Now, I'm talking a lot. Now, this is a type of human. This is like a trait. For me, for example, I'm not a sharer. I'm like a viewer. I'm always on and like watching. And some people are sharers. If you find yourself to be sharing constantly, you're going to find, it's going to be easy for you. And if you find yourself that doesn't want to and is a little bit hesitant, then you'll have to push yourself because authenticity is so important, right? Being you, sharing the moments that aren't good. This is what makes people feel connected to you. Like, I have an influencer, for example, and I won't name her, but I've seen her and I've watched her from the minute she was in to she's given birth, she has a kid, what the kids' names are gonna be, voting. I mean, she's let people in for every big moment. She's let people in on the bad moments too, during hard times in her relationship, the kids, this, that, the other, health issues. you feel like you know them. As an influencer, this is how you need to make your audience feel towards you. They need to feel connected and like they're your friend. Another big tip for my influencers out there is get over the perfection. Honestly, it's gonna stop you from hitting your goals. I hate being like mean about it, but it's true. We get so caught up in the perfect photo, the perfect edit, the perfect caption that we don't end up posting. And it's not just you, okay? It's like literally everyone I talk to. So I know that this is a common theme, and that's why it's in today's video as a tip. If you are, next time you're writing that caption out or editing, I hope my voice pops into your head and says, just post it already. Just post and move on. Don't worry about the first post, the last post, any of the perfection fears that we have. It's better to get it out there. Obviously, you need quality content. I'm not advising that you just throw junk to the wall, but I don't also want you to let perfection stop you from making moves. Now, something I don't see influencers doing enough is focusing on creating viral style content. So in my group coaching classes, I often talk about creating content that's gonna catch the eye and help you stand out. As an influencer, if you look at yourself as a leader in this space, you wanna create content that has a viral nature to it. So what do I mean by that? Don't just post replications of what other people are doing. Add your own spin, push yourself creatively. You know, see what type of content goes viral and ask yourself, why did that go viral? Sit there, sit back, analyze viral content and push yourself to create something that you think is gonna get picked up, not only by your audience, but shared by others. The goal as an influencer, like I said, is to create true influence. And by pushing yourself creatively, you're showing that you're a thought leader and that you're someone that isn't just like a follower, but setting the trends instead of following the trends. And as an influencer, so many times I feel like we may forget that this is supposed to be our role to be at the forefront. So definitely don't forget to put emphasis on this part of your business. Now, another big tip to my influencer friends out there is practice makes perfect. Remember the first time you went live on Instagram, how awkward it was? The camera was maybe up your nose, or the first time you went and did stories live. And then now you're like, oh my God, why did I overthink that? I could have told, I can do that like walk in the park. Well, it's like that in everything. And especially being an influencer, you just have to practice. It's all about putting yourself out there, you know, showing up for your community. Even when you don't want to, you'll start to get good at it. It's a muscle. You have to train it, right? If you were to get up right now and I was to say, hey, go run 10 miles, you can't just do that. You need to practice getting there. So it's the same thing with like showing up for your community and gaining confidence. Sometimes people are like, Nina, how do I see so many people actually, especially in my group coachings and in my one-on-ones too, like confidence is a reason so many of my clients aren't getting ahead. They're just not confident enough. They have this imposter syndrome. And what it comes down to is practice. The more you do something, the more you feel better at it, the better you feel at it, the more confident you will feel and appear. It's all about pushing ourselves little by little, setting small challenges that are achievable so that you guys can get there and reach your goals. Now, one thing I want to stress as an influencer, you guys have to treat it like a business too. So a big tip I'll have for you is, I know content's important and all those things that you guys think is really like the forward facing stuff, but don't forget behind the scenes. Don't forget to check your insights. Don't forget to be on top of industry trends. Like if Reels comes, I want you guys being the first to post Reels. If there's a new social media, I don't know, function or feature, I want you guys to be on it. Again, this leads back to my first point about having influence and being a thought leader in your niche. So as important as all the forward-facing stuff is for being an influencer, so is the back end. So is having a strong grasp on your biz. And of course, if you need help with that, you can work with me directly and the links to do so are below. So hope you guys like this video on my influencer tips, especially for my Instagrammers. If you did like this video, leave me a comment. Let me know what tip motivated you, what pushed you, and what tip are you looking forward to implementing in your influencer business? I read all my comments, so make sure you leave one. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do. And I will see you guys in the next video.